Hi there, I'm Andrew Brown. Welcome to Real-Time Music and Sound with Pure Data. In this episode, we're going to look at polyphony with audio objects. Whenever we create a synth sound in Pure Data, it's often useful to have several voices of that one sound. And in this video, we're going to use the poly objects and the clone objects to do that. So let's start with the poly object. The poly object takes two arguments. The first one is the number of voices that we want, and the second one is whether or not we want voice stealing. The input to the poly object is from a note in, takes the pitch and the velocity, so it knows when notes are started and stopped. And if we have a look with just some number boxes at what comes out, we'll get an idea of what the poly object is doing. Oops. So there are three outlets when we play on our MIDI controller. These are the values. So this first outlet is the voice number. It goes from 1, 2, 3 up to the number 4 in this case. The second is the pitch, and the third is the velocity. So the voice number is going to work to allocate these notes to particular voices in our abstractions. So how do we make use of that? First thing we need to do is to pack the data into a single stream to pass into the clone object, which we'll get to in a second. You saw that the numbers before that came out here were 1, 2, 3, 4 in this case, up to 4 voice polyphony. The clone object counts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, so we need to subtract 1 from that for use in that case. Then we just pass the other values, the pitch and the velocity, through. So then we get to the clone object. So the clone object looks for an abstraction. So that's like a PD patch, which is saved into the same directory as our main patch that can be brought in. If you may recall, you've been watching this video series, we created in a recent video a monophonic synth called Monosynth as an abstraction. So we're going to use that in this case. What I might do for the minute though is just start with one instance of it only, because we've got some changes we need to make to it. So I'm going to change a poly just to 1. All right, so when we pass this in, now our monosynth currently has a couple of other inlets, and so we'll need to make some edits to that. So I just click on that, and here's the monosynth. So it's got a subpatch for its oscillators, for its filters, and for the envelope generators. You can see that it's looking for a pitch, then the on velocity and the off velocity. So we need to make some changes to that so that this works fine with our pack object. First thing is we'll just take one inlet, and that will take this packed array. And so we need to unpack that data. Now you'll notice that I'm only using 2 outlets for unpack, even though there's 3 that come in. The first one is used by clone itself because that is the number of the voice, and then that's the other 2 are passed on to the particular abstraction, in this case the monosynth. So that means we're going to get pitch out of here and velocity out of there. We can use that to isolate the note on using strip note. So pitch and velocity, and then the pitch can go into our oscillator to control the frequency, and then our note on velocity can go into our ADSR envelope down here to control the attack. We also need to pass the velocity into our release inlet on the amplifier stage in order for that to trigger the release portion of our ADSR envelope. So then there's audio that comes out, as you can see here, from that monosynth. So we pass that audio to our DAC. Connect that up. Let's see. I got a couple of errors here, which is just some warnings from PD that these changes that I made to the monosynth need to be saved. So I will do that. I'll reopen it again so we can see it. Let's hear. Okay. And indeed. The pitch is not sounding all that amazing. Let me just have a look inside here. Okay. So, we just need to make another change. I was expecting to get a frequency rather than a MIDI pitch, so we'll put the M to F in here to change the MIDI note number into a frequency and resave that. That's more like it. Okay, so that's all working. So in a sense, if we all just wanted to kind of conclude here, we could do so. We can create a four voice polyphony for our poly. We can create four of these monosynths, and then we magically can play chords, and we get four voices. Fantastic. There's one other thing that we can do as well, and that is to pass values into all of our synths. Our filter is looking to receive a cutoff to change the cutoff frequency. So if we have a send object to send that value, then we can use, for example, a control input from my MIDI controller. So we can just pass that directly in. All right. And you can hear that if we play several notes, then the cutoff frequency is changing all voices simultaneously. Okay, excellent. The other value that we set up in this monosynth is to change the release rate so it can get shorter and longer notes. So this release rate variable here, we can do a similar process. Copy that. Use a different controller, the next one, number 81, and send this message, release rate. Okay, so now we play. Very short releases. Longer releases. Shorter and longer. Okay, so we now have a polyphonic synth made from our monosynth. And we can notice that we can send these changes to all of the voices in that synth simultaneously. So have a go at making all of your monophonic sound sources polyphonic, and I will see you in the next video.